Hi, my name is Machine Wright, and this is Understanding Fortnite. Getting a mechanic to the point where you can perform it 100% consistently and creative is only really step one. Step two is making that mechanic implicit so that you don't have to think about it when you're performing it. So the best way to do that is actually by performing large sets. And what I mean by large sets is basically a large number of reps. And basically performing the same mechanic a bunch of times in a row rather than performing it every once in a while during free building. And one thing I want to also make clear is that free building is not practice. Free building is a warm-up. I would actually relate free building to something on guitar that people call noodling, which is basically when you don't really play anything, you don't really practice anything, you're just sitting there and you're just messing around and just practicing improvising. And with guitar, it's actually a very well-known thing that is not a good way to practice. It's actually often discouraged by most teachers. So why is this bad? So the problem with free building is you practice one technique and then you're already moving on to a different technique. And this basically skips an opportunity I call the self-correction window. So when you're trying to improve a mechanic, it's often performed partially by your conscious memory or your working memory, and a little bit by your subconscious memory or your implicit memory. And every time you perform it, your working memory is doing a small amount of self-correction on the next rep. You cannot really self-correct on the first rep because you don't really know what you're getting into. And that's just because Fortnite mechanics are so complex and there's so much feel and just estimated timing involved that it's really hard to just jump into a mechanic and automatically start correcting it. Now, the self-correction window, I would say, is about 5 seconds. And within that time, that's when you want to perform your next rep so that you can self-correct and incorporate all of the adjustments that you want to make that mechanic more efficient and better. If you look at a lot of Raiders maps, specifically the ones that he puts practice in the title, you'll notice that a lot of his drills are actually set up this way, to actually perform that same edit sequence many, many times in a row. And Raiders actually said that he prefers this method of practice, and it's obviously worked really well for him. And believe it or not, Raiders actually gotten this method from his experience with playing piano. The art of practicing instruments in general is very, very developed just because those instruments go back to thousands of years ago. Even before it was proven with science, it was proven through experience that if you perform something over and over again and self-correct yourself over and over again, it's much better than practicing something a little bit and then shifting over another thing for a few seconds and going back and forth. So any of those complex retakes that you've been learning that have like 16 steps, I would actually break all of those down into their individual sequences and start practicing those over and over again. And I wouldn't even practice the entire retake in a sequence to begin with, just because it's not easily applicable into a build fight. It's much better to have a bunch of different sequences that you can use to react to different things that your opponent is doing than just crank out the exact same sequence every time anyway. Now, I've sort of been indirectly recommending this type of practice with my goal-oriented practice, and really the goal-oriented practice is just like a superior version of this, because not only are you practicing the same thing over and over again in a row, but now you actually have a motivation to do something well, as well as putting a little bit of pressure on yourself as well, which is always good to make these like boring creative practice routines a little bit more interesting. So yeah, very simple video, but I think it's a super important concept. Mechanics are the most important thing in the game, not only because of the obvious reason, but also because the better your mechanics are, the less you have to focus on them, and the more focus you can put towards good decision making and game sense. If you panic in fights, there's always a deeper reason. You can put pressure on yourself as much as you want and die as much as you want in fights, but that's not going to fix your problems. That's like saying the best way to become a good soldier is to go to war right away without any training and throw yourself into battle. And we obviously don't do that. We have something called boot camp where we apply that stress in a very structured way in reasonable amounts. So although arena is good practice, I think it's better to start off with playing a lot more creative, getting all your mechanics really solid, making them as implicit as possible. And once you get into arena, your mechanics are not going to take as much focus as they normally would. This is going to allow you to make much better decision making. Generally, when you are panicking, it's because you don't know what to do. So having a free conscious memory because your mechanics are so good is going to help you figure out what to do in those situations, just because you're going to have that free space to do that when you don't have to focus as much on your mechanics. When you have good mechanics, you're not going to make as much dumb mistakes, which means you're not going to have to VOD review as much, and you can also get to the point where you can pretty much notice your mistake as you're doing it, just because you have that extra focus to do that, and you can actually self-correct while playing. As soon as you die, you can automatically know why it happened. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks, guys.